Hello, we are the SpaceX fans and welcome to the SpaceX Show, the place where you can stay up to date with everything SpaceX. Earlier today, SpaceX successfully launched their 52nd mission of the year with the launch of NROL 146. The booster which launched this mission, B1071, then landed successfully for the 16th time on the drone ship Of Course I Still Love You.
Landing leg deploy.
There are a whole bunch of missions this week and next week that we can hopefully expect to see. The first of these, the Starlink 662 mission, is scheduled for tomorrow, Thursday 23rd at 2:35 a.m. UTC, or today, Wednesday 22nd at 10:35 p.m. EST. Then we can expect to see another Starlink mission launch later tomorrow. The Starlink 663 mission is currently scheduled for tomorrow, Thursday 23rd at 10:45 p.m. UTC or 6:45 p.m. EST. Then, going into next week, we can hopefully expect to see yet another Starlink launch. The Starlink 660 mission is currently scheduled for Monday 27th at 11:30 a.m. UTC or 7:30 a.m. EST. Then, the following day, we can hopefully expect to see a customer mission launch. The EarthCare mission is currently scheduled for Tuesday 28th at 10:20 p.m. UTC or 6:20 p.m. EST. SpaceX posted a video saying, first, video call on X completed through Starlink direct-to-cell satellites from unmodified mobile phones. We are excited to go live with T-Mobile later this year. Heading to Boca Chica, the suborbital tank farm is in the process of being demolished. Another old tank farm tank's cryo shell was seen being lifted to be scrapped. They then began cutting the tank shell into pieces. The GSE tank itself was also lifted off of its stand to be scrapped. A bunch more Launch Tower 2 sections were seen being rolled to Starbase. In response to a video of Musk explaining why 301 stainless is the best material for Starship, Musk posted some information. He said, the SpaceX Advanced Materials team has since developed a new metal alloy far better than 301. Earlier in the week, SpaceX did a Flight 4 wet dress rehearsal of the full Starship stack. SpaceX posted some pictures of the wet dress rehearsal and said, launch rehearsal for Flight 4 complete. Musk posted some information about when we can expect to see Starship's fourth flight. He said, Starship Flight 4 in about 2 weeks. Primary goal is to get through max re-entry heating. Worth noting that no one has ever succeeded in creating a fully reusable heat shield. Shuttle required over 6 months of rework. After the full stack wet dress rehearsal testing, Ship 29 was de-stacked from Booster 11. Related to Flight 4, we also have some promising news on a date when we could expect to see it launch. This post says we have actual flight testing activity closures for June 1st or June 2nd, 3rd if necessary. Additionally, there was a picture posted on Reddit of a not mar or notice to mariners of June 1st for the possible launch of Starship. It says not mar and road closure scheduled for launch activities on the 1st of June. So, based on this news, let's take a look at the Cameron County website where there are some possible closures. The possible closures are for next week with Tuesday 28th, Wednesday 29th and Thursday 30th. Then they have possible closures for Saturday 1st of June, Sunday 2nd and Monday 3rd. Additionally, SpaceX also have temporary closures for today, Wednesday 22nd, tomorrow, Thursday 23rd and Friday 24th. As always, I have to say thanks to both Sean Doherty and Mary, otherwise known as Boca Chica Gal, for being out there filming the Starbase content. Also, thanks to the NASA spaceflight team working behind the scenes on their videos, live streams and other space content. That's it for this episode of the SpaceX Show. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure to hit the like button and leave a comment down below. If you want to stay updated with SpaceX info, make sure to subscribe and press the bell icon to get notified when I upload. Thanks for watching and have a great day.